Hello everyone, I am Rohit and welcome to my YouTube channel AI Era. So guys, in this today's video, I am going to discuss with you Python object and Python data structure. Along with Python object and Python data structure, I am going to create a variable and apply a various mathematical operator such as addition, subtraction, multiplication, division on that variable. Also in that video, I am going to show you one of the special operator known as mod operator. So without doing any delay, let's get started. So guys, here I can enlisted a various kind of data structure that contains in Python. So total 8 types of data structure that are available in Python. The first is integer. Integer contains a whole number. For example, a 3, 30 or 300. Basically, Python used to indicate this number or this type of data structure by using an int, that is int, int. Then the second is a floating point. The floating point is nothing but number which having a decimal point is known as a float. The next is a string. Anything in a quotation mark is known as a string. The next is a list. The list is defined as a list, and anything in a square bracket, anything means it contains a tuple, it contains an integer, a floating point or string, that all the combination it contains in all combination of data structure are contained in a square bracket, then it's known as a list. Dictionaries. Basically, dictionaries are defined by the curly braces. And the dictionaries are a pair of keys and value. So the first variable is known as key and the another variable is known as a value. Then the next is tuple. Anything which described in a circular braces is known as a tuple. Set and dictionaries are defined as my curly braces, but the main difference between sets and dictionary, in dictionary we have the dictionaries have the key and value pair, where sets are used to identify the unique value from my list. Then the next is booleans. Booleans are in nature of true or false. So here is my total 8 types of data structure that are available in the Python. So don't worry guys, from the next lecture or from the upcoming lecture, we are going to discuss in more detail about each and every data types that are available in Python. So we're moving towards our next agenda, that is create a variable and apply a various mathematical operator on it. Therefore we have to move towards our Jupyter notebook. So guys, here I am in my Jupyter notebook. So these two cells shows that a Python program output a hello world or hello AI era. So that is my first program that I'm created using a Python programming language. So if you want to get more insight about how to write my first program by using a Python programming language, then the link is below in description. So please check it, and we move forward to create a variable. Before going to create a variable, I just take a 2 number and apply a various mathematical operator on it, and let's check the output. So I just take a 2 plus 3, and I run this or execute this particular cell by pressing shift enter, and here it shows me the output 5, 2 multiplied by 3, and here it shows me output 6. You can see over here, I just write my number with my mathematical operator in a particular cell, and below that it gives me the output. Then here I'm going to assign a variable, and I'm going to assign that a variable with 2, means the value of 2 is assigned in the variable a. Then I call initiate another variable, that is b, and I can 10 in my variable b, and I can execute this particular cell. After that I can apply various mathematical operator on it. So for storing this particular result, I have to create another variable called c, and I just say a plus b. So guys, you can see over here. Here when I'm going to add a 2 number, then the output it shows immediately below of that particular cell. But here it does not show me result. When we assign a variable, we have to use a print command. In print command, we have to type in which variable we are store our result. In this program, I am store my result in C variable. So I can just print C over here, and it shows me output. Instead of C, I can write as a result, and here I want to print my result. You can see, guys, it prints out my result. But you can get your result without writing a print command. Just you have to write your variable that contains your final output, that is result. And after writing result in a particular cell, you have to press a shift enter, and it will show you result over here. So I can change my operator as division, and I can check the result. So you can see over here, it shows me result. Multiplication operator. As I said earlier in today's video, I am going to discuss about a special operator known as mod operator. So I just comment it out. So in Python, for comment anything, we use a hashtag. I just create a comment over here, a mod operator. The symbol of mod operator is a percentage sign. The mod operator will give us reminder after the division operation. So it will give me a reminder after a division operation. So if I take this two number, that is 23, mod operator by 2, and it will give me a reminder as a 1. But instead of, I just take this two number, 50, mod operator by 5, here reminder is equal to 0, because 50 is perfectly divisible by 5, and I have to press and shift enter. So you can see over here, it will give me output 0. You can create a variable also, so that a is equal to 50, b is equal to 5, and c is equal to a, or result is equal to a mod operator b, and print result. To execute this cell, I have to press and shift enter, and it will show you the output. For a summary, in today's video we are to see various kind of data structure that are available in Python, and next we have to create a variable, assign various mathematical operator on them. And we are take more insight about our mod operator. And from next video, I am going to start with a string. Stay tuned on my channel. From next video, we are going to start with a string, and we are going to see how to slicing, indexing operation are carried out on the particular string. So stay tuned on my channel. Please subscribe my YouTube channel, that is AI Era. If you like this video, please share with your friend. And if you feel anything wrong, and if you want to give any suggestion, please comment out your suggestion in the comment section below. Thank you, one and all.